Stead Slacks, everybody's favorite. America, let's go. Steve Stout confirms that Drake actually did get invited to perform at the Super Bowl. Jay-Z has been the creative coordinator slash producer for the Super Bowl for the past years. Look, I ain't sure Jay-Z's exact position at the Super Bowl committee, but they said that he's running the show. That's what they're saying as well. Jay-Z really chose Drake to perform? Now, what's wacky about that? Drizzy and Jay-Z seem to be having a slight shadow war for the past few years. Between the title dynamic, Drake saying that Jay-Z is becoming a bit unrelatable from that Rolling Stone interview like 10 years ago. Drake getting that opportunity to perform at the Super Bowl after all of this is extremely interesting, and he also never announced it one time. That could change the perception of the Super Bowl line and first-person shooter. We know Drake is creatively involved with the World Cup in 2026. Remember that Canada is hosting it that year. Drake is also like a cultural ambassador for Canada. So America, Dame Dash reported several days ago that Drizzy showed an interest in Jay-Z's Reasonable Doubt Masters. Whoa! Steve Stout also spoke on this as well. Now, America, I want y'all to peep this.
Twice, which is fine. He didn't want to do it. But nobody's going to say, damn, why'd you turn it down? You could have got Lil Wayne on. Mm-hmm. Right? Nobody.
Well, this is also a little bit disingenuous too, right? Like, you know, I heard Wayne talk about possibly, and I could play that clip. Again, we've kind of exhausted the whole Wayne Super Bowl angle. Wayne clearly stated, he said, hey, if I did get the Super Bowl, I probably wouldn't even fuck a guest. Like, this is my moment. Like, I'll probably rap their version, their verses and whatever on whatever song I'm going to perform. So it's clear that Wayne wants to headline a Super Bowl, not just be brought out like, oh, hey, come out and perform a milli, then go back into purgatory, right? He wants that moment, right? And I think he does deserve it, right? Like, this is one of the greatest artists of all time. He does deserve the headlining moment. So that kind of negates a little bit of what Steve Stout is saying, because Drake headlining and then bringing out Wayne is not Wayne's moment, right?
Everybody's going to connect that dot. The other thing is that no one seems to think about is, why isn't Jay-Z picking himself? Like, he's not even being selfish about it for himself.
By the way, somebody told me Albiel in the building. Yo, shout out to Albiel if you're in the building, brother.
He didn't want to do it. But nobody's going to say, damn, why'd you turn it down? You could have got Lil Wayne on. Mm-hmm. Right? Nobody's going to connect that dot. The other thing is that no one seems to think about is, why isn't Jay-Z picking himself? Like, he's not even being selfish about it for himself.
Now, answer that. I mean, the culture supported him being in that position to get the move. Like, you know, this idea that Jay-Z is almost like the rich king that's just saying, here, you peasants, let me give to you. No, Jay-Z used cultural support to get to the room to get this deal. If Jay-Z was seen as, I don't know, name a black entertainer, people don't like them. For example, if Jay-Z was me, like, obviously I'm not as great as Jay-Z, but like, if Jay-Z was 50 Cent, he wouldn't get to that room. Jay-Z wasn't as polarizing as 50 Cent. 50 wouldn't get to that room because when 50 says something, the entire culture doesn't go with it, especially at that time. Jay-Z had the support of the culture. So to act like Jay-Z's just, you know, just, oh my God, he's just so great, he's giving back. Nigga, no. It's like, you know when they say you're voting for a black candidate? Yeah, we're voting for the black candidate to do shit for black people. Like, yeah, we gave you the cultural currency for you to get in there to pick the rappers. Yeah, like, what the fuck? Like, this is not no, you're not gifting us some shit. You don't get there without everybody saying, oh no, we rock with Jay.
Why isn't somebody saying, man, you know what? He's actually making a decision based off of what he thinks the best performance is at the right time, music, etc. because he's not even using this moment for to satisfy himself. He has catalog. He can rock.
Yeah.
He's nice. He's not even choosing himself. To me, that should be celebrated, that he's not being selfish and he's helping these artists and giving them what they deserve and not being selfish about it and choosing only, you know, Rock Nation acts or himself. Because if it was just that, I could understand.
Well, Rihanna, and by the way, this isn't a good point, but I'm making it anyway. Rihanna did perform, like, she popped up, like, you know what I mean? Anyway, but still, yeah, I don't think he's really prioritizing Rock Nation artists. And I mean, honestly, let's think about who's on Rock Nation. The only people who would be able to perform that would deserve that stage would have to be Rihanna. Is J. Cole still on Rock Nation, I guess, right? Yeah. J. Cole couldn't headline. Like, with all due respect to J. Cole, you're not a headliner of the Super Bowl, right? But, like, yeah, I could see you popping out. Right. So Rihanna, Jay-Z, and Beyonce, right, which are all Rock Nation, right? And then you have J. Cole. Who else? Who else is on? Who else is on Rock Nation? Anybody else? Like, bro, if I see Meg Thee Stallion popping out, yo, Meg Thee Stallion's supposed to be twerking at Kamala Harris rallies. You're not supposed to be performing at the fucking Super Bowl. Get the fuck on out of here. Right, I can't imagine who else on Rock Nation could even be in a discussion. Now, here's the thing, like, you could be biased to your people, but you can't just, you know, just like put something that don't make sense. Somebody said Kanye's not on Rock Nation. Lil Uzi Vert, I'm gonna be honest with you, we love Uzi, but Uzi at the Super Bowl is not a thing, bro. Okay, I love y'all, and I'm not saying. Maybe at some point it won't be. But if you announce that Uzi's headline the Super Bowl, come on. Keep in mind, you have to realize the Super Bowl is the singular biggest American sporting event where it's going to have the most eyeballs. The average consumer that advertisers are trying to appeal to, they're in their 40s. Lil Uzi Vert appeals to 16-year-olds. I'm not saying all 16-year-olds because, shit, I'm in my 30s and I fuck with his music, but... his music doesn't go to 40-year-old white men. You get what I'm saying? So they're not picking him, right? They got to pick an artist.
So, yeah, Jay-Z is one of my favorite rappers all the time, right? Mr. Sean Corey Carter. Steve Stout saying Jay-Z could have chose himself. But if Jay-Z did that any other year, who would he have chose to perform after? After Jay-Z performs at the Super Bowl, how much bigger does it get? Now, my generation, people born in the 80s and 90s, like I was born in the 90s, right? We would enjoy seeing Jay-Z. I know I would. But in terms of Rock Nation artists, who's there? You could use J Balvin if you wanted to go for the Latin international market. J. Cole, as academics mentioned. I could see J. Cole headlining in about another 5 to 6 years. Yeah, that would make more sense then. When I think of him, I don't really think of stadium rock and arena music. J. Cole doesn't pop into my head for that. And Rihanna did it already. So Jay-Z, if he would have chose himself, that's really the only other option that I could think at this point. And I'm not sure about what's going on with his contract. I think he did sign for about 5 to 7 years. And once again, I'm not sure. If anybody knows, y'all let me know in the comments and make sure y'all subscribe, all right? Because we breaking this down. Once again, who knows? Maybe Jay-Z could choose himself next year. Who knows? Drake performing, the ratings would have been pretty epic. And it's interesting that Jay-Z offered Drake that opportunity, even with some slight tension between them. Not sure if that was a play or anything, but that is interesting. And remember, Mal broke that. Mal from Rory and Mal podcast. Then Elliot Wilson confirmed it. Then we hear Mr. Stout validating these claims as well. Let me know. Y'all think academics was wilding? He's also expressing that Jay-Z didn't get to that position without working with the public perception, and we definitely spoke on that as well. Hov moves always fare very well with the public consensus. I actually think the most smoke he ever caught in terms of the public perception was the Super Bowl decision to let Kendrick perform. I heard one person even mention that Jay-Z would pay somebody to not speak on something if a deal went wrong. Like, he'll pay outlets to not even publicize a deal just to keep that public perception squeaky clean. We know Jay-Z and public perception goes a long way. In academics, he made a solid point as well about why would Drake bring Lil Wayne out when Wayne is the one that signed him. Even that seems kind of weird. It's like chess. I'm wondering, why would Jay-Z offer Drake the opportunity to perform when there's all this background tension? Could that have been to maybe create some type of animosity between him and Lil Wayne? And I'm only asking that because, look, one, we see that these guys is not cool like that. Yeah, I get what we're saying. Like, that perception that we had of the industry, everybody's cool, they're having sleepovers and they're in the studio, everybody is all friends. And no, like, Nicki Minaj and Ye, they been was telling us that that's not what's really going on. It's a lot of sunning going on. It's a lot of underhandedness going on. They're going to say you got paid for something, but you ain't get paid for it. That's what's going on. It's not just your artists and the nobodies that never made it in the industry that complain about it. Big artists, A-plus artists, getting finessed by A-plus artists at different times. So, America, this situation right here, it's a very interesting one with Drake in the Super Bowl. I'm gonna keep it a bean. They was trying to finesse Drake and Wayne. Because why would you reach out to Drake, but you wouldn't reach out to Wayne? Steve Stout saying that Jay-Z should have performed. Well, how would the ratings have looked? Because if I'm not mistaken, with the Super Bowl, the ratings are very important as well. Now, Jay-Z, I'm sure millions of people will definitely watch. But at the same time, my generation, the 80s, the 90s, we'd be excited to see Jay-Z. But now Jay-Z, he's on a super executive type of time. It would be amazing, but like, I'm not sure if like, it would be even like Kendrick or Drake. Of course, it would be legendary the same way. When it comes to ratings, how y'all think that would have done? But y'all let me know in the comments what y'all think. Y'all know it's Legs and it's Astrosthetics. Let's get it. Pay. B. Yeah.